In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Some people here are not listening. Are you listening? It's a very, very familiar story about the prodigal son. How many of us here have heard about the prodigal son? Yes, we have heard about the prodigal son. Then you put your hands down. We want to talk about the prodigal son and what he did, where he went, and what happened to him until he came back home. And as we are going, as we are thanking the Lord for the opportunity, for the time that he has given us, I want you to listen very, very carefully as I am reading that story in Luke chapter 15, and I want to read from verse 11. Sinaskia, follow with me. And he said, now this is Jesus Christ speaking, a certain man had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that falleth to me. And he divided unto them his living. He sat again. Sorry about that. And he said, a certain man had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of the goods that falleth to me. And he divided unto them his living. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together and took his journey into a far country, and there wasted his substance with riotous living. And when he had spent all, there arose a mighty famine in the land, and he began to be in want. And he went and said unto himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him into the field to feed swine. And he would fain have filled the belly with the husks that the swine did eat, and no man gave unto him. And when he came to himself, he said, how many hired servants of my father's have bread enough to spare, and I perish with hunger. I will arise and go to my father, and I will say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee, and I am no more worthy to be called thy son. Make me as one of the hired servants. And he arose, came to his father, but when he was yet a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion, and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. And the son said unto his father, I have sinned against heaven and in thy sight, and am no more worthy to be called thy son. But the father said to his servants, bring forth the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand, and shoes on his feet, and bring hither the fatted calf and kill it, and let us eat and be merry. Now, in Luke chapter 15, we have three things that were lost. First of all, there was the lost sheep. And what did the shepherd do? The shepherd left 99 and went to look for this one sheep. Also, there was the lost coin. And here we are finding here that the owner of the house, the lady of the house, was sweeping and looking everywhere trying to get for that lost coin. And then there is the story of the lost son. Now children, let me tell you, everything that we say, everything that we do, there is always consequences. Everything that we say, everything that we do. This young man, he rose up and he went to his father and he told his father, Father, I want you to give me everything that belongs to me. Now, there was nothing wrong with that, except in their culture, you could not inherit your father's property if your father is still alive. But this father was a good father. He went ahead and he said, all right, if that is what you want, I am going to give you property. And what does the Bible say? When he was given his inheritance, what did he do? He went to a very far country. And there, he started to misuse his money. Now, children, was that a good thing to do? Was it a good thing to do? Are you sure it was a good thing to do? It was not a good thing to do. Because when you are given your money and it is in your inheritance, you need to invest that money. You will need that money later on. But this young man just said, this is my money, let me go with it. I am going to buy everything that I want. So he went everywhere, he bought everything, and things that really, some of it, he did not need. So very soon, he ran out of money. He ran out of money. And when he ran out of money, things were not very good on his side. You are in a far country, you don't know anyone, you don't have money, you don't have food, you don't have somewhere to sleep. So he became very desperate. And do you know what he did? He went around the town, and he went and he found a man who was keeping pigs. And he told that man, I need a job. And what did this man tell him? Okay, I have a job here. If you can take care of my pigs, just go and take care of the pigs. And listen, children. Imagine a young man who came from a father from somewhere, a young man who had a lot of money, a young man who had a lot of future ahead of him, is now actually taking care of the pigs. The food that the pigs were eating is the same food that he was eating. So his decision was not a very good decision. He needed to sit down. He needed to ask himself, here is money that I have been given. This is all I have. My father has given me everything. What am I going to do with this? And so, he wasted his money with a riotous living. Do you know there are many, many, many people today who are wasting what God has given to them? The Lord has given them life, they are wasting that life. The Lord has given them hands to work, they are wasting their life because they are not working with their hands. They want to get things for free. So this man, he went the wrong direction. He made a wrong decision. And so as we are going for the holidays, as you children, as you are graduating today, how many of us want to go to class one? All of you. And that is a very good thing. The class one teachers are waiting for you. Put your hands down. But you know, you have to work hard. And do you know, when you are wearing this gown, do you know what it means? It means that you have worked very hard. And it is just the beginning. So, the Lord is going to bless you. The Lord is going to walk with you. We are going to pray for you that even when you go, the Lord is going to keep all of us. And the others who are not graduating, as the Lord is going with you for the holidays, and this time we are not going to go for a whole month, we are going for a very short time. A very short time. So I am sure some of you, your parents will not take you up country. So when you go back home, please make some wise decisions. Have you been watching news?
Yes.
Have you heard about children who are getting lost?
Yes.
Go and somebody comes and tells them, you know, Daddy, I have a sweet here for you. Just take this sweet. But we do, you know what? Come with me. I'm going to buy you even more sweets. Then what do you do? You follow. So when you see a stranger and they come and they give you sweets and they tell you, go with me, How many of us will go with them? Don't go. Because you have seen how the parents whose children have gotten lost, how they are very sad. Imagine a child disappears, you are very young, maybe the age of McKenna here. You are very young, somebody has taken you, and you don't know them. It is not good. So I am appealing to all of you, be very, very, very careful. Don't just talk to anyone. Don't just go to anyone. Don't leave your house without telling your father or your mother that, Daddy, I am just down here, I'm playing, I'm coming back, so that they can watch over you. Are you going to promise to do that?
Yes,
do that. And then also, don't just take your time to roam around the estate without doing anything. I am sure when you are going home, your teachers will give you homework. And if you are going to work hard, if you are going to make a good decision, you must sit down during the holidays and do your homework. Please make sure that you don't go home with your classwork, that you go home to do your classwork and your homework together. Because that is not good. That is not a good decision. Classwork is done where? In where do you do your classwork?